We've had so much happen over the last few months that we don't want our employer members to forget some changes that took place on January 1. One of the key changes that happened on January 1 was the legalization of recreational use for marijuana. And this creates some potential challenges for employers, especially if you already have drug-free workplace policies in place or zero-tolerance policies in place for drug use. And even if you don't have those specific type titles in your policies, most of you, if not all of you, will have some level of policy in place that deals with drug use and employment. So this creates some potential challenges, and we just want to cover a couple of those things and some of the caveats that are already built into this particular law and how it protects the employers as well. So let's get going on that. So one is, it doesn't preclude you from doing that. It also doesn't preclude an employer from doing drug testing. So if you already do drug testing, all of those things are perfectly acceptable as they would have been before. It's important. However, you're not able to discipline somebody that works for you or not hire someone because they are legally using marijuana outside of the office place. In other words, on their own time, the night before, the weekend before, or whatever else the case may be. Now, this of course is going to bring up some potential challenges for those policies and potential problems. So what does the law do and how does it protect you as an employer? Well, there's a couple of things and we're going to cover it in a couple of different videos, one this week, one next week. So we'll cover the law specifically that took place and was enacted on January 1. So now, when can you prohibit? Well, the biggest thing is this, is you can prohibit the use or impairment, and this is important, both use and impairment in three different areas. One is within the workplace itself, so in your office building. Two, while they're performing job duties. So if they're running errands or whatever the case might be, if they're doing something for your office, of course you can restrict the use and the impairment. And then the third is while they're on call. So if you have somebody that's on call, you can also prevent usage as well as impairment during those times. Now, all right, so most of you are saying, okay, that's nice, Mark, but what about this impairment thing? Because what if they're not lighting up now? What if they, you know, what if they smoked some marijuana in the parking lot before they got out of their car and now they're inside my office? Is there really nothing I can do? Well, no, that's not the case at all. Actually, you still are potentially able to make a difference. And here is the key. The key word is impairment. And so the law actually gives employers some specific language and things that they can look for. So if you suspect drug use and you see a reduction of job performance that you believe is directly related to impairment, here are the factors you can consider when reviewing an employee, when looking at the employee and studying an employee. One, speech, their physical dexterity, their agility, their coordination, their demeanor, if they're exercising irrational or unusual behavior, if they're negligent or careless in operating some of your equipment, whether it be the interferential machine or the copy machine, if they have a disregard for the safety of themselves or the safety of others, and that would include other employees as well as your patients. And then also if they're just careless, if they have carelessness that results in the injury of themselves or another employee or any of your patients or other people in your office. Any of those things would be factors that you could consider. Now, what does that really look like? The key is you have to have a good faith belief that those impairments are negatively impacting their job performance. In other words, their job performance has diminished as a result of those particular impairments. And so the locations, again, workplace, while performing an employment task, or if they're on call, and then I went through the list already. If you need some more information, we got some more information out there in our Cannabis in the Workplace article that's out on the website. Now, this is also really important. Next week, in our video next week, we're gonna talk about the Privacy Act because there's some protections for employees and workers in the Privacy Act that really have to be taken into consideration when you look at your zero tolerance policies and your drug-free workplace policies or your drug policies in your office. We'll touch on that next week. You all take care.